and I carve a mean turkey. And my turkeys are amazing. Hi, I'm Zaw Thet. I'm the founding partner at Signia Venture Partners. I am a longtime entrepreneur turned venture capitalist, and I'm a proud investor now. So I actually dropped out of school when I was 19 and started my very first company, and have since gone on to start multiple companies over the course of 12 years, and then took a little bit of a break, semi-retirement, didn't know exactly what I wanted to do, and ended up starting my own venture fund. It's hard because every pitch is a little bit different. I will say I think the characteristics of what I look for are basically an amazing team, right? You got to start with that. I think it's important because when you hit obstacles, you're going to need help and you're going to need support, and it's really hard to be a one-person show. Passion and confidence. We're mainly looking for people to answer the why us and the why now questions. So those are the types of things that I would typically like to see in a pitch. A problem and then a solution kind of after. And I would say a couple of the things that we typically, or that I typically get turned off by, would be hubris and a lack of transparency. So don't treat it as anything different. Go in and just be yourself. And if they don't like that, then they aren't the right investor for you.
So I want to know what gets you excited about a deal.
Yeah, making a lot of money. A pitching sucks no matter what you're doing, no matter who you are. Making a deck or a set of slides, right, about your company is actually really important because it allows you to basically get your thoughts down into a very clear and concise manner. Because what investors are really looking for is that, are you a good storyteller, right? Or can you tell a story about why your company is going to succeed? I like that question. A legacy question. What would I want it to be? I would want it to say that he changed the world for the better. And I think I can do that both through capitalism, and I think I can do that also through philanthropy. I'm lucky enough to have had a lot of success, but I've also had a lot of failures. And I think that's important to recognize. To me, like, my proudest thing has always been going from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm, and just being able to really learn from them and take them as feedback. If you find yourself in the shower more than one day in a row thinking about not your job but your other thing, go try. Because you can always go back. There are very few opportunities and things. If you find yourself caring that deeply about something, go try. So, welcome to my weekly stretching. Oh, I have so many nerdy habits. Where do I begin? I'm an emoji guy, but I use GIFs too. I would say here are my most frequently used emojis.
Thumbs up, that's a standard. Thank you. You rock, a lot of monkeys. Fingers crossed, I apparently made the cut. I feel like I use way more than these.
I don't know if I have any hidden talents. What are my hidden talents? I would say I'm not a bad cook. And I carve a mean turkey. And my turkeys are amazing. I will say that. And now raise it up like right here. Okay, so our tomato kick is... When I was first starting my company, my first company back in 1999, there was nothing. I had nowhere to go. I literally would buy as many books as I can. I didn't understand what a Series A meant, or what a cap table meant, or what anything meant. Now you actually have too many resources. You have all these people with all these different opinions. And so a credible set of resources and a community that other entrepreneurs can work with each other, talk to each other, is, I think, something that's really sorely needed. Let's level the playing field and make something that's independent from everyone, that's connected into great organizations. That's why I think Alice is mission critical and super important.
Perfect. Whenever you're ready.
There's no, like,